the whole idea of Enigma 3 and the lyrics and everything are talking about the circle of life. Partly it's very normal, talking about daily life stuff, and partly it's philosophically.
The first is the father. The second is the mother. And the third is the child.
Michael Cretu or not Michael Cretu, that's not important, because at the first album my name even wasn't written on the album, and I think names and persons are not important. I try to show also the other side, pure music.
Take a deep breath.
Basically, it's like a kind of humanized instrumental music. And humanize that with vocal samples and from strange cultures. My intention always was, and my dream always was, to show to the people that you can mix really cultures and same music from people with complete other skin colors, and to build it to a kind of United Nations of music. And I think that the third album is the best example for it. The title of the new album, Roi Est Mort, Vive Le Roi, should symbolize the circle of life.
Le Roi Est Mort, Vive Le Roi.
It's for me one of the most intelligent and at the same time paradox phrases in history. Because it's strange if in one phrase you say, okay, the one is dead and yoo-hoo, without breathing in between, the other one is alive. But it symbolized that life always means changings, even when it seems that everything remains the same, and still there are changes.
Things are changing, but nothing changes. And still there are changes.
I think that to express my feelings and my thoughts, music is for me the best language I know. I think there are no special secrets about my work. The only thing which makes it a little bit different to other kinds of music is that I have to really dive into the atmosphere of the song I'm working on. Sometimes it takes a pretty long time, but as soon as I arrive into it, then it's very easy to choose the right sounds, say the right beats or whatever, to realize the atmosphere, what I was hoping or dreaming of in the back of my mind. Sorry that my name is appearing so much on the album compared to other albums, but I can't change the situation that Enigma Project is to 95% a one-man band. And through my musical education and my studies and so on, I really can do many jobs. I'm the producer, I'm the composer, arranger, sound engineer, and what shall I do? It is how it is.
I look into the mirror.
the lyrics, they are very complex, and it's very hard from time to time to get to the quintessence, because I never have long lyrics, and to make in a few lines, say, the quintessence of a whole thing, this is pretty hard till you find the right words.
The lyrics are quintessence of the sound material which will follow.
There's no teacher who can teach anything new. He can just help us to remember the things we always knew.
The global success of the first albums means for me much more than recognition of my work, because it symbolizes that we are basically the same, only maybe the color of the skin or some details in religion and whatever makes us a little bit different. If not, there's no explanation why, say, a Japanese like In Nomine Christi Amen, and say a Christian likes Hindu music. That shows us that music is a really universal language, and that always was my intention to try to find it out if it is what I think or not. And with the first two albums, I have the best proof, and then I can say my work makes sense. Never was an intention of mine to have Enigma music, say, as a medicine, or say something which helps people in therapies or whatever. But it helped me, and I received a lot of letters from different countries where really people say that they are using it in some situations, and say patients feel better, and say impressions or responses like this make me very happy. Yeah.
My favorite is Morphing Through Time, because it's really weird, and the whole complex, I mean, and I like it very much, because it's a little bit like some people who heard it, okay, it was a big compliment, they said it's music for the next century, because it's a little bit like Debussy in pop music, you know, it's something which I think it's before its time. Imagination and fantasy is the only thing what is the engine which brings us forward. Our imagination and our dreams always were our engine.
Enigma on stage, it's also a question, but I would say at the moment, I will describe it as a science fiction. I don't think that the huge success of the first two albums, with over 25 million sold units, changed me. It's only stimulating to go on this way and try to find maybe new strange things and work on it. But I think as a normal human being, say, which I think I still have both feet on the earth,